वेलकम स्टूडेंट्स, दिस इज रविशंकर। इन दिस वीडियो वी आर गोइंग टू स्टडी अबाउट द नेक्स्ट टॉपिक कॉल्ड टू बी इलेक्ट्रोस्टैटिक इंडक्शन। व्हाट डू यू मीन बाय दिस इलेक्ट्रोस्टैटिक इंडक्शन? सी, वी आर गोइंग टू स्टडी अबाउट एन टॉपिक कॉल्ड टू बी electrostatic induction. While you are studying this lesson initially, we have stated that we can able to get a charge to be induced in an material by the process of rubbing, and then by taking that charge nearer to another body, the charges can be induced. The charges, we are calling it out as induced charges. So we have studied that the charges can be obtained in an body by the process of rubbing, or by having a contact with one body, we can able to get the charge of that body. Is it possible for a body to get a charge without touching or without having any contact with each other? That can be explained with the help of a demonstration in your book. That phenomenon, what we are calling it out as electrostatic induction. So we can write the definition first of all, and then we will be going with the demonstration. See, the phenomenon of inducing charges, phenomenon of inducing charges from one body to another body, from one body to another body with or without actual contact, with or without actual contact, is called as electrostatic induction. Is called as electrostatic induction. See, this is a general definition, but when I am going through your book, it was being given that the phenomenon of inducing charges from one body to another, and in your book they have given only this one, without the actual contact, is called as electrostatic induction. But in general, electrostatic induction can be told or defined in such a way that the inducing of charges from one body to another body with or without the actual contact, that is called to be electrostatic induction. So in order to explain this, let us go with a demonstration. So what is the demonstration that we are going to look here? See, what is the demonstration? In order to study about, or in order to consider about the demonstration, you consider an metallic sphere which is properly insulated from ground. So it is placed over an wooden stand, or I can say a plastic stand, somewhat an insulated stand from the ground. See, when you are considering this sphere, which is made up of a metal, so I am taking this as a metal sphere. In case of this metal sphere, which is a conductor, you are having so many number of free electrons. And let us consider that free electrons are distributed uniformly over its surface. So we can say, as long as no external electrical field is applied to this metal sphere, the charges or the electrons are distributed uniformly. So I can write, as long as no external electrical field is applied, no external electrical field is applied, the electrons or the charges are distributed uniformly, or distributed uniformly over its surface, or let us just consider uniformly. Now what I am going to do, now you consider another charged body, consider a charged body. See, this charged body may be an ebonite or an plastic rod which is being rubbed with some suitable material. So usually we will be considering a plastic rod or ebonite rod. So a plastic rod or an ebonite rod rubbed with wool or fur acquires negative charges. So consider a charged body, that is a plastic rod or an ebonite rod. Now what I am going to do, I am taking this plastic rod nearer to that of what? Nearer to that of this metallic sphere. So I am drawing the diagram on the other side or near here. So I am drawing this diagram again. Now what is the second diagram? The second diagram is you are having this charged, you are having the sphere, uncharged sphere, and now it is placed on the insulating stand, properly insulated. Now I am bringing this negatively charged rod, either plastic rod or ebonite rod, nearer to that of this conductor. So this negatively charged rod brought nearer. When this negatively charged rod is brought nearer, the negative charges available on the nearer side of, see, on the nearer side of this sphere are repelled away, and they are getting piled up on the other side, leaving it vacant spaces or leaving positive charges at the nearer end of the rod. As long as this negatively charged rod is placed nearer, these positive charges are held by this negative charges, and negative charges are repelled away. When you are removing this negatively charged rod, then again this sphere will become uncharged. This we are calling it out as charging temporarily. This is not given in your book. But what it is given in your book, this is the first step and this is the second step. What is the third step that we have to follow? Now you are having what? Now you are having the negatively charged rod kept nearer to that of this sphere. See, when you are keeping the uninsulated sphere from the ground nearer, due to the presence of this negative charge rod, at the nearer end you are having the positive charges, and the far end you are having the negative charges. What I am going to do is, in the presence of this negatively charged rod, I am touching this sphere on the other side, or I am connecting the other side of the sphere with the help of the wire to the ground. This process we are calling it out as earthing or grounding. It is otherwise called as what? It is otherwise called as earthing. Since human body is a conductor, it is not necessary that you have to connect a wire to the ground. You just touch this sphere for a moment. When you are touching this sphere for a moment, since you are having a contact with the ground, or when you are joining the sphere with the help of a thin wire to the ground, all the negative charges which are available at this end are leaked out to the earth, leaving out only the positive charges in that sphere. So now the positive charges alone are in that sphere. As long as this negatively charged rod is kept here, the positive charges won't move. They will be held in this position by this negatively charged rod. Now the fourth point, what I am going to consider. See, I am taking that sphere which is insulated from the ground, and this is having the positive charges now. Now what I am going to do is I am going to remove this negatively charged rod from this. When I am removing this negatively charged rod from this, the positive charges which are being held in this position by this negative charges are now free, and so that the positive charges will be moving over the surface uniformly so that the sphere gets charged permanently. Now the sphere gets charged permanently. So in this method we haven't got any contact with the charged body, but the uncharged body is now said to get charged. This phenomenon we are calling it out as electrostatic induction. What is that phenomenon? The phenomenon of, I have written, the phenomenon of inducing the charges. So from the negatively charged body, the sphere is acquiring positive charge. So the phenomenon of inducing charges from one body to another without actual contact is called as electrostatic induction. See, where we are using this electrostatic induction, there are so many examples. So in our book we are going to discuss two types of examples in later stages. One is lightning arrestor. One is lightning arrestor. You might have seen lightning arrestors on top of the buildings, top of the towers, etc. In Tamil it is said that idirangi. Similarly, we are using this in some other concepts called to be corona discharge, or we can say a device called as Van de Graaff generator. This is a generator which can able to produce a very large potential. So in the final part of the lesson, we will be studying about these two concepts. There I will be explaining this, how this concepts of electrostatic induction is being used. This we are calling it out as, or this phenomenon we are considering it as electrostatic induction. Then we will be going with the next topic. The next topic available is dielectrics, or otherwise we can say it out as non-conductors, or we can say insulators. See, already in the previous part of this lesson itself we have studied that conductors are taken to be the materials which can allow the charges to flow through, and the materials which won't allow the charges to flow through are called to be insulators or dielectrics or non-conductors. We are going to study about that dielectrics or insulators in this part. So the next topic that we are going to study is dielectrics, or it is otherwise called to be insulators, or in general they are called to be non-conductors. So what do you mean by this, dielectrics or insulators or non-conductors? See, in general we can say the materials which won't allow the charges to pass through. The materials which won't allow the charges to pass through. Allow the charges to pass through. We are calling that materials as dielectrics. I can say so many number of examples. Wood, then plastic, rubber, etc. See, but in your book the definition that was being given is in terms of technical manner. That is, the materials which is not having any free electrons in it. So this is the definition that is given in your book. This definition you just use it for understanding. So materials that as no free electrons in it to make conduction possible. To make conduction. That materials are called to be dielectrics, to make conduction. All the electrons, you can say like this also, all the electrons are bound to the nucleus of the atom, or bound to the, or bound to the atoms of the material, bound to the atoms of the material. That type of materials are called to be dielectrics or insulators or non-conductors. When you are considering the example, you can say the same examples, that is wood, plastic, rubber, etc. What will happen to a non-conductor when an external electrical field is applied? See, when external electrical field is applied, then also the electrons are not free to move. See, let us consider a note here. What is a note? See, when an external electrical field, when an external electric field is applied to an insulator or to a dielectric, then also there is no free electrons. But the electrons that are available will arrange themselves in a definite way or in a specific way. But the electrons, are aligned in a specific way, in a specific way or in an definite way. So this we are calling it out as dielectrics or insulators. About this alone we are going to study. See, when you are considering this dielectrics, there are two types of dielectrics available. So I am writing it like this. When I am considering this dielectrics, there are two types of dielectrics available. One, I am considering it as polar dielectric. The dielectric is called to be polar dielectric. And another one, I am considering it as non-polar dielectric. So what do you mean by this polar dielectric and non-polar dielectric? First of all, I am considering the polar dielectric. See, these materials are made up of polar molecules. That is, this polar dielectric, let us consider like this, this polar dielectric. These polar dielectric materials are made up of polar molecules. So what is meant by these polar molecules? Let us see later. In the next session we will be seeing it. So when you can say that molecules as polar molecule, the center of the positive charges as well as the center of the negative charges in an atom are not coinciding with each other, they are separated by a small distance, then that molecules are called to be polar. Then the dielectric materials are called to be polar dielectric. We can state so many number of examples. What are the examples that I can consider? See, the examples that I can consider are water molecule H2O, then nitrous oxide N2O, then hydrochloric acid HCl, and ammonia NH3. Like this, we are having so many. Similarly, if you are considering non-polar dielectric, in this similar way, I can able to explain. how I can explain about this nonpolar? See, materials that are made up of nonpolar molecules. Okay, so I can write nonpolar dielectric are the materials which are made up of nonpolar molecules. Nonpolar molecules. What is that nonpolar molecule? See, I can consider like this: the center of the positive charge and the center of the negative charge. Center of the positive charge and the center of the negative charge are coinciding with each other. The distance becomes zero. Such a case, we are calling it out as what? Such a case, we are calling it out as the nonpolar molecule. See, when you are considering this nonpolar molecule, I can say some of the examples. Examples of nonpolar molecule may be nitrogen, oxygen, carbon dioxide are considered to be some of the molecules in which the center of the positive ion and the center of the negative ion are coinciding with each other. So now we have to differentiate between the polar dielectric molecules and the nonpolar dielectric molecules. So how I can able to differentiate the polar and nonpolar dielectrics? First of all, I am considering nonpolar dielectric or nonpolar molecules. So the first concept that I am considering is, in order to find or study the difference, I am considering the nonpolar dielectrics. Or this nonpolar dielectrics are considered to be made up of nonpolar molecules. See, for this nonpolar dielectric, I am first of all writing some of the examples. Examples may be, I have already written oxygen, then nitrogen, then I can also consider hydrogen, I can consider carbon dioxide, etc. If that is the case, how I can able to differentiate? The first point for nonpolar molecule is, in case of nonpolar molecule, I am writing like this, already I have told, the center of the positive ion and the center of the negative ion, center of the positive ion and the center of the negative ion are coinciding with each other, that is, at the center both positive charge and the negative charge are one over the other, are coinciding with each other. Number two, let us consider the second point. Since the distance between the positive charge and negative charge is zero, this nonpolar dielectric or nonpolar molecules are not having permanent dipole moment. Since the distance between the charges, positive charge and negative charge, or positive ion, negative ion, is zero, the nonpolar molecules or the nonpolar dielectric, the nonpolar molecules are not having, the nonpolar molecules are not having permanent dipole moment, or not having permanent dipole moment, because dipole moment is charge into distance. Here the distance is zero. But what will happen if you are applying an external electrical field to that nonpolar dielectric? So let us consider the point number three. See, point number three is, When an external electrical field is applied, when an external electrical field is applied to this nonpolar dielectric, the center of positive ion or charge and the negative ion, center of negative ion, get displaced by a small distance, get displaced by a small distance. See, when I am applying an external electrical field, they get separated. That is, the positive ion and the negative ion, which are coinciding at the center, are now displaced by or get separated by a small distance. So then what is the point number four? I am writing the point number four here so that I can able to summarize. Since they have separated dipoles as well as dipole moments are induced. Dipoles as well as dipole moments are induced. Because due to separation, you are able to get dipole as well as dipole moment. So, dipole moment are induced. Such dipoles are called to be, if you are considering that a dipoles, positive charge and negative charge are getting displaced, then separated by a distance having the same nature, same value but with opposite nature, so the dipoles are now considered to be induced dipoles. The dipoles are induced dipoles. And the dipole moment is called to be. And if you are considering the dipole moment is called or considered to be induced dipole moment. Induced dipole moment. So when you are applying an external electrical field, then only the positive ion and negative ion are getting separated. And after getting separated, we can say that dipoles are induced and the dipole moments are also induced. Then let us go for point number five. See, what will happen to the dipole moments? All the induced dipole moments will get aligned in the same direction of the external electrical field. This is point number five. Then let us go for point number six. See, when you are applying external electrical field, the dipoles are induced and the dipole moments are induced. And when the dipole moments are induced, all the dipole moments are said to align in the same direction of the applied electrical field. The above phenomenon. What is that above phenomenon? Aligning of all the induced dipole moments in the same direction of the external electrical field. So, the alignment of all the induced dipole moments in the same direction of the external electrical field is called as polarization. So, the above phenomenon leads to polarization of dielectric. So what is meant by this polarization? Let us define it at the final part of this concept. What is polarization? Aligning of all the induced dipole moments in an nonpolar dielectric in the same direction as that of the external electrical field is called to be polarization. Hope you should have understood this. These 6 points, we are calling it out as the important properties of nonpolar dielectric. Now I have to consider the polar dielectric and I have to explain again the above 6 points for the polar dielectric or for the polar dielectric molecule. So the next concept that I am going to consider is polar dielectric. See, similar to that of the previous case, I am going to write the points. What is the first point? See, for polar dielectric, the first point that I am going to consider is in the in non-polar, I have told that both the positive charge and negative charges are coinciding. Here, what is the case? First of all, we have to say some examples, isn't it? So, some examples, I can say water molecule, ammonia molecule, NH3, then nitrous oxide, N2O, then HCl, etc. So, what is the first point? So, I am considering the first point like this. Here, in case of polar, here, that is polar dielectric or polar molecules, the center of the positive ion, okay, the center of the positive ion and the center of the negative ion and the center of the negative ion are not coinciding but separated by a small distance. Since they are separated by a small distance, they may have a permanent dipole moment. A diagram can be drawn like this. You are having a positive charge, then a negative charge. Both are separated by a small distance considered to be R, R, D, R2A, etc. So this is the first point. What is point number two? Point number two is, since they are being the both charges of equal magnitude, opposite nature, separated by a small distance, these polar molecules are said to have permanent dipoles and permanent dipole moments. So we can say polar molecules are having permanent dipole moments, are having permanent dipole moments. So this is the second point. But these permanent dipole moments are oriented randomly, but they are not aligned in a particular direction. They are oriented in random manner. Since they are in random manner, one effect of one dipole moment cancels the effect of another dipole moment. Therefore, the net dipole moment is zero. Since they are in random direction, the net dipole moment is what? The net dipole moment is zero. Then let us go for point number three. What is that point number three? You have to apply an external electrical field. What will happen? See, already they are having permanent dipole moment. By applying an external electrical field, what will happen means the orientally arranged or the randomly arranged electrical dipole moments will be arranged in a particular direction. So the third point is, when an external electrical field is applied, that is, external electrical field is applied to polar dielectric, the randomly arranged dipole moments will try to align in the same direction of external electrical field, in the same direction of external electric field. This is the point number three. So let us consider point number four. What is that point number four? See, when you are considering an external electrical field, all the dipole moments which are randomly arranged are said to align in a same direction means net dipole moment is induced. It is not equal to zero. So we can say, therefore, net dipole moment is induced in the polar dielectric when when it is placed inside an external electrical field. See, when it is placed in external electric field. Okay. So what is this phenomenon then? By aligning all the dipole moments in the same direction, the above phenomenon is taken as polarization of polar dielectric or polar molecules. This we are calling it out as the properties of the polar dielectric. See, along with I can able to state what is polarization. I can define polarization also here. So what do you mean by this polarization? Polarization is a phenomenon where the total dipole moments per unit volume, or I can say the phenomenon of aligning either the induced or the permanent dipole moment in the same direction as that of the external electrical field. So we have to explain a lot. So let us go with this phenomenon polarization in our next class or in the next video. Hope you should have understood an important concept regarding dielectrics. Thank you.